today I'm at the Brampton Road Test Examination Center that is right behind me, and we're doing a mock-up exam of the G-Full Road Test, so your highway test. We're gonna do it from start to finish and give you tips and tricks so that you can pass yours from the first time. Let's do it. Okay, so here we are in the car. You have to park and in a certain spot here that is numbered, and I'm here with my friend who's gonna guide us through the full test today. So let's get started.
Hey guys, so when you park your car in the road test center, it's a good idea to park your car backwards, because when examiner gonna come to you, to verify your ID, ask your address, and make sure you know your postal code. Then he goes around your car making circle check, like checking signals left and right, brake lights, make sure you have full tank of gas or at least half tank of gas, and your tires should be in good shape. And then examiner sit down in your car, and it's a good idea you start your road test just going forward. So it's a good idea to park your car like backwards. Okay, and then we start in the road test. Right now we're gonna go through the G-Full road test, or its right name is like G2 exit. You exiting from the class G2. And if you pass the road test, you're gonna get a class full G. You're gonna be a full G licensed person. So it's two parts. It's a city and a highway. And here in Brampton, it's usually first part is the highway, and then you're going through the city loop. Okay, so let's get started. If you're ready, buckle up and let's go left if it's safe. Make sure you yield for all pedestrians and people in front of you, all cars, because here in Brampton Examination Center is pretty crowded, and there's some people like too excited, and they go in like under the wheels of your car like very easily, so pay attention for the people. Okay, if you're ready, let's go left.
Okay,
yep. So here we're exiting from the numbered parking spots, and here we're turning right. And this stop sign, examiner will ask you to make one more right turn. Yeah, it's a stop only for us, not always stop, it's stop only for us. And here at this road, examiner will say, okay, let's make a 3-point turn here. Right away, in the beginning of the road test, you're making 3-point turn. Should be no cars in front, no cars behind, no any people. Yep. Yeah, when you're going backwards, make sure you physically look at the back, like this. Okay, and here's two pylons, should be two pylons. It's examiner will ask you to make a parallel parking, so let's make a parallel parking. You see these spots?
Mm-hmm.
In between these two spots you have to make a parallel parking.
Okay, there will be pylons here.
Yeah,
just not
it will
here
be
right
pylons
now.
So okay, make sure you practice your parallel parking a lot. You should be like, you have to make it pretty confident. No hesitation, your movement should be like nice and smooth, and your parking position, you shouldn't touch the pylons. An ideal parking position is like 1 foot from the curb or 30 centimeters from the curb. You can go back and forth, but if you can make it like from the first attempt, yeah, that's good. And park your car, use your parking brake.
Yep. And if you don't know how to do the parallel parking, there's another video on the channel that you can check out.
Okay, let's get out from here.
Okay.
So you did already 3-point turn and parallel parking. Okay, mirror signal, you're checking your blind spot all the time. It's like formula MSB, mirror signal blind spot. Okay, going straight. Here we have a couple of bumps. Don't go too fast. It's pretty hard bumps here. And we're going straight. Till stop sign, first gulf. And this stop sign is only for us, and here we're making a left turn. We're going towards Steels Avenue. Okay, your full stop, before stop line or before... Yeah. Some cars going pretty fast in here, so pay attention. Okay. So after left turn, you switch your lane to the right. Automatically, examiner will not gonna ask you to make a, to switch your lane. Yeah. Yellow means stop if you can do it safely. If not, then you proceed. So we're going straight to Steels Avenue, and we're gonna make a right turn on Steels and going toward 410 highway. 410 highway, we're gonna go north. It's a major highway, 400 series, speed limit on the highway gonna be 100 kilometers. On the streets in Brampton it's like 50 by default. If it's if we have speed limit signs, it might be speed, you're gonna go with speed limit, but if not, it's like it's 50. It's gonna be school zone in the city, at school zone is 40.
Pedestrian?
Yeah. Pedestrian, yield for pedestrian, yield for traffic from the left.
They have to step on the curb, right, before you can go?
Yep. Okay, so wait, patiently. Yeah, it's Brampton is getting busy. Okay. Okay. You switch your lane. And we're going straight, and speed limit on Steels is 70. So keep going straight.
Are we going north?
South? We're going north. Yeah. First one is the south, we're not going south, we're gonna go north. So after the bridge. Okay. Going straight through this traffic light. Speed limit 70. If you can go 70, if you have some cars in front of you, like make a distance or keep your distance. And here we're going, we're exiting 410 north. Recommended speed on this curve is 30, but 30 kilometers per hour is going to be too slow, so plus 10 from recommended speed is my advice to you. So 40 is going to be good speed. It's one lane, nobody passing you here, you just like go 40 and then you have to accelerate. Acceleration lane, you have to accelerate till 100 and then you merge on the highway. It's a main idea. Make a signal in advance. Yeah, speed limit is 100, is good. Okay, and here examiner usually ask you to make a lane change. It might be left and right, or maybe left right. Okay, if it's safe, let's make a lane change to the left. Mirror signal blind spot, and you check your rear view mirror like from time to time, every 5 to 10 seconds. Okay, change your lane right, please, if it's safe. If you have some cars, be patient. Okay. And we're going to be exit to Clark Boulevard. Okay. And then on Clark Boulevard we're going to turn and going to enter highway again. It's like two times you enter in highway, two times you exit from highway. Okay. Exit to Clark. And first coming traffic light, we're gonna turn left. Recommended speed is 50. It's a good idea to be on the second lane.
Second lane is better?
Yeah, second lane is better because like...
Oh, we have to change lanes again?
Yeah, after turn we have to change lane to the right and enter highway again. And we're gonna go 410 south now. So it's my preference is the second lane because you don't, after turn you don't need to change your lane to the right. But if you are in the left lane, it's, yeah, you just turn in the left lane, then you switch your lane to the right and enter in highway 410 south again.
When is the best time to do the test?
Yeah, it's usually in the morning after rush hour. My, like, I love time after 9:30 in the morning, 9:50, 10:20, 10:50 is like my favorite time. Till probably maybe 2 o'clock. After 2 o'clock, after 2:30 is getting busy. So. Okay, let's, yeah, we're gonna make a 410 south. Okay, recommended speed again is 30, you're going 40, and your acceleration should be pretty energetic. Speed up till 100 and then you merge on the highway. Acceleration lane is pretty long here, so yeah, you can do it easily.
Okay, I'm already at 100 here.
Yeah, and here's the speed limit sign 100, okay.
Signal.
Yeah, signal, you merge. Okay, once again, examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left if it's safe. Let's make it. Okay, and let's make one more lane change to the right. And one more lane change to the right. Yep. And we're exiting on Steels Avenue. Okay. Steels Avenue, on Steels Avenue we're gonna turn right. Okay, and first coming traffic light we're gonna turn right. Recommended speed is 50, you're slowing down. And keep in the right lane. This coming traffic light, Steels Avenue, we're gonna turn right. Now highway part is done and it's city part is beginning right now. And if you can see, speed limit on Steels is 70. Okay, we're going straight. Okay. And let's make a lane change to the left. It's gonna be lots of lane changes. Examiners, they need to be sure that you are comfortable with this one. And we're going straight till Kennedy, and then Kennedy, we're turning right on Kennedy. When you're crossing the traffic lights or intersections, make sure you're checking your left, right, left. Just turn your head physically left, right, left. Not only your eyes, but like your head. Okay, change your lane right, please, if it's safe. Okay, going straight. We're going straight till Kennedy. If all traffic flow is going slowly than 70, you're going with traffic flow speed. But sometimes it's an empty road and all traffic going faster. Then you go keep your speed 70. Change your lane to the right. We're gonna turn right on the Kennedy.
Another yield here for
pedestrians. Yield sign, make sure no cars from the left, no pedestrians. Okay, going straight. If you can see speed limit sign, 60. It's 60 on Kennedy, and examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left. Okay. Because you're gonna turn left. Okay, this traffic light, we're going straight. Check left, right on the intersection. And second traffic light, we're gonna turn left.
So, this one here?
Yeah, right? This one we're gonna turn left. It's a special lane for left turn. No, не здесь, на следующем же еще.
This, okay, that's awesome. Next one.
Okay, speed limit is 60. Yeah, this one we're turning left. It's Tullamore Road. Yeah, complete your turn. If traffic light is changed and you're already in the middle of intersection, just complete your turn. Okay, residential area, if you have no speed limit signs, you're going 50. If you have school zone, it's 40. It's gonna be very soon school zone. And at school zone, make sure you're going 40. Like, control your speed constantly. This coming stop sign, we're turning left. Pay attention if it's stop sign only for us or it's a full stop sign. It's Barley Bowl Parkway. We're going left. First come, first go, always stop. Calm residential neighborhood. At this street, examiner will ask you to make a roadside stop. You know what's a roadside stop or emergency stop, and make sure you know where's your four-way signal emergency button in your car. Okay, let's make a roadside stop or emergency stop right here. Okay. Arm brake. Yep.
And then the wheels we turn. It's downhill, so it looks like downhill.
Yeah, it's a flat road, or maybe a little bit downhill. You turn the wheels to the right towards the curb. Yeah, this is your roadside stop. Okay, let's go straight.
Okay.
One of the most common mistakes people like forget to off four-way signal. So, yeah.
Yeah, don't forget to turn.
Don't forget to turn it off. Yeah. Okay, and school zone begins right here. 40 begins. You have pretty like lots of school zone signs. Every 50, every 100 meters you have a school zone Okay, always stop, first come, first go. You stop your car before the stop line. If you have no stop line, you stop before the sidewalk. If you have no stop line, no sidewalk, before border of the road. Speed limit is 40, continuing here. Pedestrian cross, check left, right, no pedestrians.
And here there is no stop sign.
No stop sign, we keep going straight. Yeah, speed limit is confirming 40. We're going straight. And now the always stop. Check your rear view from time to time. Okay, first come, first go. No pedestrians. School zone, school zone. Sometimes when it's a school time of the year, we have a crossing guards here. So pay attention for crossing guards. It's a practically, this street is like, there are two schools. Yeah, we're going straight. No stop sign here. Keep going. It's a good idea when you start slowing down, you check in your rear view. Like, make sure, like, you know about the cars behind of you. Okay. And this coming stop sign, we're going left. It's a Orchard Drive. We're turning left towards Steels. Okay, well.
She didn't stop.
Yeah, this guy just don't care about make stop on a stop sign. Okay, and this traffic light, it's Steels. We're turning left and going back to examination center.
Left or right?
Left.
Left?
Okay, no oncoming cars, no pedestrians, you check in your blind spot. Speed limit is 70 on Steels, you remember that, and after left turn you have to switch to the right by yourself. Examiner will not gonna ask you to switch your lane to the right, but like right lane for your driving, left lane for passing, and by law you have to be on the right lane. And it's a good idea to be on the right lane, because you're gonna turn on to examination center to the right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're gonna go through a couple of traffic lights, Kennedy and another one, and then we're gonna make a right turn on the first Gulf.
Can you drive with one hand?
No, it's a good idea. Like, the main idea, your steering wheel should be always under control of your hands. It's a good idea, like, concentrate and try both your hands to be on the steering wheel. Because we don't want to make examiners
to be nervous.
So your steering wheel should be under control. It's a good idea, use both hands on the steering wheel. Okay, we're going straight.
Here we have 70.
70 and change your lane to the right. It's a big Home Depot, store, big box store right here, and then you're turning right to the first Gulf Boulevard, going back to examination center.
Another
yield sign, make sure no cars on the left. Two lanes on from the left should be free, two lanes, should be no cars. Okay, and this traffic light, we're going straight. Yellow means stop if you can do it safely. If you have enough time to stop, stop. And then after this traffic light, Biscayne, first entrance, it's our entrance to the road test center to the right.
And we're gonna do parking.
Yeah, and we're gonna do parking. On the highway road test, examiner, It's the duration of the test is usually 21, maybe 22 minutes, and examiners, they pretty tight in on time, and usually they ask you to make a front-end parking to the empty parking spot. So, for example, you start your road test from the parking spot number 5, but at the end of the road test, examiner will ask you to park anywhere in the just empty spot. Okay, and this stop sign we turn in right. And let's make a left in the first row. And examiner will park your car anywhere here. Let's make a front end parking to the right. Usually it's to the right, but if it's gonna be, yeah. Okay, that's it. Make sure your car in between two lanes, and if you have another cars beside of you, it should be enough room for you and for examiner to get out from the car. You can fix your position, but it's good idea to make a parking like in one shot.
Okay,
that's it.
And then we turn off the car.
Turn off the car, and examiner say, "Okay, you pass." Okay.
Yay! We celebrate. Yeah. So you get your answer right away.
Right away. Result. Then you have to go to examination center to.
And yeah, there might be some lineup, I guess.
Some line, yeah.
So you have? Do you have to wait again in lineup? Probably not. Probably you just go straight.
Right now it's a line in here. I don't know.
You'll have to ask
right
your examiner.
Right now it's a COVID-19 situation. Time is like how
different
they're gonna
rules.
Proceed is like they changing rules like every day. But examiner will tell you if you pass like right away at the end of the road test. If not, then you have 10 days, and after 10 days you can book another road test. But good luck, guys. You have to pass with our video. You have to pass a road test like from the first attempt, and make sure you're gonna go through this route like several times to be familiar, and you'll be more confident and comfortable with this route.
And you're not going to be as nervous when you're actually doing it, because you've done it several times.
If you know where to go, like what to expect, it helps a lot.
Okay. Thanks for this. Thank you for watching, guys. If you have any questions, comments, let me know in the comments or send me a message. And good luck. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.